What's up, guys? Welcome to the Grokshop. So my little YouTube channel is finally starting to take flight. Thanks, fam. And I wanted to add a little companion blog to it. Just wanted something simple, cost effective, and where I was in control. So I decided to go with a WordPress.org site that I hosted on a virtual private server. So I'm using Linode because we've already been using Linode to host a site for my wife's big YouTube channel, and we've been real happy with the service there. Plus, Linode makes it super easy to set up a WordPress site. You guys won't believe how easy this is. Just watch. If you don't already have a Linode account, just hit my referral link and they'll get you set up over there. Once you get your account set up, just go ahead and log in. Once you get logged in, hit the big blue create button. Next, click Linode. Next, click one click. Now click WordPress latest. Okay, next scroll to WordPress latest options and enter your admin username, which is your username. You can change username later, but it's not super easy. So try to pick something you really like and then enter in your password and email address. Next, you can go ahead and enter your website title now if you want. You don't have to. It's very easy to change later. As of this video, there's no real option for selecting an image. It's straight Debian 9. You see the little checkbox there, so nothing to do there. Next, you need to pull down select a region, and this is basically what data center you want to use. Just try to pick one that's centrally located to your audience. Okay, next you need to select your Linode plan. I recommend going with a Nanode because it's the cheapest at only $5 a month, and you can always resize your Linode later. Okay, next you can set your Linode label if you want. It's just for your own identification, mainly if you have multiple Linodes going. You can always change this later easily if you want. All right, now you can set the root password for the Linode itself. This is for the underlying OS, not the same necessarily as your WordPress password. Okay, now if you know what SSH keys are, you can enter them here. If you don't know, don't worry about it right now. Okay, now we can hit that big blue create button and watch the magic. Okay, after about less than a minute or so, you'll see the little status area go from busy to offline to running. All right, now what we can do is grab our IP address and test it out. So just select your IP address here and copy and paste it into a new tab. What you should get is the Apache default page, which is the web server that runs underneath WordPress. So if you just type /wp-login.php after the IP, you should get the login page for WordPress. At the login page, you should be able to go ahead and log in with the WordPress admin credentials that you created earlier. Once you get logged in, you should see your WordPress dashboard where you can customize and configure your WordPress site. So after that initial login, it'll create a default Hello World post for you. Now you can go back to your IP address and see what that looks like. So at this point, you're live. The world can see you at this IP address. It doesn't look like much. It's just the plain default. But of course, you're going to do your customizations and get your first post out. So I'm not really going to get into how to use WordPress here, but I will go ahead and create a first blog post by clicking this Write Your First Blog Post. Okay, so next order of business, we need to get our domain name attached to our IP address. You can do this by adding an A record at your DNS host. A lot of people will just use their domain registrar. For me, in this case, it's namecheap.com. But you can also have your DNS hosted by Linode, and I found their name servers to be quite reliable, so that's what I'm going to do here. So now I just click the domains menu item, go to add a domain, and then enter my domain. Okay, next you need to enter an SOA email. This is an email address that's not associated with the domain name that you're adding here now. Tags is just an internal Linode organization feature. I'm not going to use that. Now we want to select insert default records from one of my Linodes, which is a really cool feature. Then just select your Linode and hit create. So now we can see the domain records configured for this domain. You should be able to see an A record for the IPv4 and Quad A for the IPv6 and even mail records. So now we just need to let the domain registrar know that we're going to use a custom DNS config. So on Namecheap.com, we go to the domain area and under name servers, select custom DNS and add in the Linode name servers, which are ns1-5.linode.com. So it could take some time for the DNS changes to propagate. That depends on your ISP and a number of factors. You should be able to ping it. Here I'm on a Windows box, so from a command line, it's just ping and then your domain. And then if you think it should be ready, you can always type ipconfig/flushdns on Windows, and that flushes out your DNS cache on your box, and eventually your ping will start working, and then you can go to your domain in your browser. Once you've confirmed your domain's working, you want to go to your WordPress settings, and under general settings, you want to head over to WordPress address URL and put your domain name in instead of the IP address there. And same for site address. Okay, so now your WordPress blog is up at your domain, but you have no HTTPS, which you really want to have. So I'm going to show you how to do that here now. So now we'll head back over to your Linode server configuration, find the launch console at the top there and click that. Next, you'll see something like this. You want to select the glish and the top right, the blue one is the selected one. Okay, next we're going to log in as root using the root password that we set up earlier. Okay, next we're going to install certbot by issuing these commands shown. And actually for these commands, you don't need the sudo since we're already root. You can leave that first command sudo off. Just a force of habit on my part and a foible, but it doesn't hurt anything. Okay, this next command will get our certificate and automatically configure Apache for HTTPS. Yeah, so now it's pretty much just follow the prompts, enter in a valid email address, check out the terms and conditions and agree or not, but you have to agree to get it to work, of course, and then opt in or not to the marketing information, and then also enter in your domain, very important. And then the last piece is to decide to redirect HTTP to HTTPS or not. I recommend you do and select number 2, and that's it, you're done. Okay, now back in our browser, we can test all this out by typing http://yourdomain, and then we should see it redirect to HTTPS, and that not secure will turn into the little padlock. Okay, now with that confirmed working, we could go back into WordPress under settings, general settings, and where it says WordPress address URL, like we edited before, we just add our S to the HTTP and save. So that's it for this video, guys. Be sure to check out the docs as I show here for more information about setting up your WordPress. But not too bad, right? Pretty easy. If you found my video helpful, be sure to thumbs me up. For sure, I'll have tons more WordPress videos and other web-related videos coming in the future, so if you guys want to be notified, be sure to subscribe. But as far as how to quickly set up your WordPress.org site on a Linode, that's how it's done. Thanks for watching.